Sebastian Vettel Martinez, MMA Nuts here, Cage Warriors 103, with a very happy and already celebrating Mads Bernal. So, Mads, you defeated Ahmed Villa via first round submission, Japanese necktie, if I'm not mistaken. How does it feel to get such a big win over such a loud and raucous hometown crowd?
Like I said to the Danish media right after the fight, it's like I fought in UFC Liverpool, and I think there was like between 15 and 18,000. This by far tops it, because everybody was on my side. It was like, it's the craziest thing I ever tried in my life. Like, a whole arena is just on their feet. Why DJ Kool, let me clear my throat, is banging on the speakers. I'm like I tried to keep my calm and like not smile, but it was like, fuck it, I couldn't keep it in. It's like, that was crazy. And then when I won, it was like,
Even some of the British media in here said this is one of the loudest crowds we've ever heard.
Yeah. Also, some of the other fight, Alexander Jakobsen from Norway, he's here as well to see me fight, one of my good friends. And he's been fighting on Cage Wars for a long time. He said, like, this is, I think this is the best setup he's seen from Cage Wars yet.
So, considering that you got such a big victory and you got two straight submission wins now, I mean, I know you said that you're going to take it to see how it comes, but I mean, what are your goals for 2019 anyway? Like, how many times do you want to fight, and what do you plan on fighting for?
I'm planning on fighting two more times and then whooping some ass, stacking some cash, hopefully, at the end. But yeah, we'll see. I'll take one fight at a time. Actually, like, this is a bit crazy, but like, the first week of training, I had a shoulder injury, so I couldn't use my shoulder like for 2-3 weeks almost. And I was this close, like for two weeks ago, I was this close of pulling out because my shoulder was bugging me so much. And like, I've been sick this camp and my shin had been fucking with me. So I was like this close to pulling out. And then I saw this, I don't know, Teddy Atlas video where he said a fight is not a fight before there's resistance. And it's like, okay, Mads, you're a pussy. You need to go in there, because a fight is not a fight before there's resistance, right? So I just take one fight at a time. I want two more fights this year. Now I want to take some time to rest my shoulder, have some fun. Like I said, I've been living on cornflakes and water for like 2 months. Now I want to get some beer, get some fried pork, and have a good time.
And considering that you had that injury, are you relieved that you managed to get him down to the ground so quickly? Because you mentioned before that he's a bit awkward standing and it was a bit hard to gauge you at distance.
Yeah, but the thing was, actually, my shoulder was bugging me the most when I was wrestling and grappling. Okay. When I was like boxing, it wasn't bugging me that much. But wrestling and grappling has been bugging me. Like, one round, it was super good. The next round, I couldn't even lift it. It was like a limp arm. Mm. Yeah, but...
All right. Well, I mean, it was a fantastic performance. And considering that you did all that with an injured shoulder, it makes it a win.
I don't want to take anything away from Ahmed. Today, my shoulder was not injured. Okay. I came in here 100%. Like, otherwise, I wouldn't have gone in here. I got treatment on it. I got some laser shit on it, Superman shit. And now it's good. Hats off to Ahmed. He took the fight with, like, 2,000-3,000 people, all in my favor. He came into my backyard to fight me. So, hats off to him. I was 100%.
All right, well, you're matching the level of expertise in the cage with some true humbleness outside of it. Always appreciated. Well, the fans at home will surely look forward to seeing you in the cage at least twice more this year, and hopefully in bigger and bigger fights. Mads, thank you very much.
Thank you, Sebastian.